Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 9th December 2017. I am Sagar Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader at Superior Profit, based in Singapore. I will not take time to introduce myself. If you are interested to know more about me, the company Superior Profit, or more importantly, how it may help you in your trading, you may visit the website www.superiorprofit.co and click on the About menu. Before we begin, we go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should only be used by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This session is not for any recommendation of buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decision made by its audience. As usual, in today's topics, we will look at key commodities, oil and gold, using Q charts. We'll study broad market in terms of market breadth and ETF technical analysis to assess whether the market is bullish or bearish. Market consists of multiple industries. The industries tend to rotate from strength to weakness based on a multitude of factors, including government policies, technological advances, commodity supply disruptions, etc. We look at industry rotation using performance graphs, ranking and heat map table with the aim to align our trades with the direction of the industry. Along the way, we may review some trade examples from Q Forum and look for potential trades for the coming week. That was the last slide of the presentation. We now move to Q systems. We begin our commodities technical analysis using GLD, the gold ETF. We are looking at it using weekly backdrop template on the left hand side and the daily hop on template on the right hand side. Together we call this Q at a glance template. This template helps us decide whether there is a Q trade opportunity at the right edge of the chart. From the weekly backdrop chart, we see that for two successive weeks, the backdrop candle color has turned magenta, that is bearish. And during both of those weeks, price came down with heavy volume. If you are following the weekly market roundups regularly, you know that our last optimal long trade opportunity came on this cyan candle. We discussed in the previous week that a fast trader could book partial profit on this cyan candle when the reward covered the risk distance. On this candle, for the second time, the trade allowed an exit at a profit point that was more than the risk in the trade. Those who didn't exit the trade would have been stopped out somewhere around this candle. The exact stop out position can be decided using Q protection signal that is available in the Q hop off template. This is the Q hop off template. The long entry in gold was taken on this cyan candle. Eventually, gold came down. At the time of entry, the Q protection signal indicated the stop loss location, which would be at this price level. As GLD came down and hit this price level, the swing long trade would exit Kyu Sung traders following discipline will exit the trade at this point and would not like to continue holding the trade beyond stop loss point. At the right edge, gold is at lower boundary. It is oversold as can be seen from the dots appearing below the candles. This is too late to try to take any short trade. If in the coming week gold goes up little bit to the value area and tilts down from there, it may give us a low risk go with flow trend following short trade opportunity. Let's now look at US oil using the same at a glance template. In the weekly chart, we have two successive candles with yellow backdrop candle color, that is neutral color. During both of these weeks, US oil tried to go down but recovered substantially, as can be seen from the long lower tails in both these candles. Activity was muted in recent weeks. In the daily chart, US oil is moving sideways with the highs and the lows at approximately at the same price levels. Because there is no clear direction, we may stay away from taking any swing trade in US oil right now. We start our broad market study using market breadth analysis. On the left hand side, we are looking at NASDAQ composite index, and on the right hand side, NYSE composite index, both using weekly charts. In addition to the two indices, we are looking at three pairs of market breadth internals, that is new high lows, the top indicator, advanced decline, the middle one, and up down volume, the lower indicator. The indices are clearly in uptrend, both for NASDAQ and NYSE. NASDAQ could not make a new all-time high. It ended the week with a very narrow range candle. Candle traffic light color is yellow, that is neutral. NYSE went up and made a new all-time high on a closing basis. For three successive weeks, NYSE outperformed NASDAQ. The market breadth internals continue to remain weak over longer term period. They are not able to surpass previous peaks. For this specific week, 1, 2, these two, that is the new high low indicators for both NASDAQ and NYSE declined. All the other four internal indicators went up. All the six internals ended in the positive. In summary, from market breadth analysis, we conclude both NASDAQ and NYSE are clearly in uptrend. Internals continue to be weak over longer term period, and for this specific week, market breadth is positive. Let's now study broad market using the broad market ETFs. Here is SPY using Q at a glance template. From the weekly backdrop chart, SPY is seen to make a new all-time high. It is overbought as can be seen from the dots appearing on top of the candles. Last week, SPY had very high activity. This week, it has high activity. In the daily hop-on chart, SPY came to value area, went to upper boundary, came to value area, and now it has gone to upper boundary again. At the right edge, it has a bullish cyan flow color candle. that is the signal of a possible go with flow trend following long trade setup. However, it is already too close to upper boundary. Looking at that, one may be cautious before taking any swing long trade in SPY right now. Here is QQQ using at a glance template. Just like NASDAQ broad market index underperformed NYSE, QQQ underperformed SPY. In the weekly chart, we have two successive candles with backdrop color magenta, that is bearish. In the daily chart, QQQ displayed a bearish headwind signal on this candle, tried to go up but failed and came down, closed below the high created by bearish headwind in this magenta candle. Since then, it couldn't go up, came down and then recovered a little bit. Next week, if QQQ declines from here, it may give us a low risk go with flow trend following short trade opportunity. What about DIA? DIA chart is very similar to SPY. It made a new all-time high in the weekly chart, and in the daily chart, it closed above the upper boundary line. It is already too high to take any long trade at this point. IWM, this is the Russell 2000 ETF, the last of the four broad market ETFs that we study. We have backdrop candle color of yellow, that is neutral. And IWM also displayed a bearish headwind sign on the weekly chart. In the daily chart, IWM went straight up from near the lower boundary to the upper boundary. This is an area we know as wild swing area. There is no clear trend and we avoid taking any trend at such areas. After that, price came to value area and over last 2 days recovered little bit. The daily charts traffic light candle color is red, that is bearish. That prevents us from taking any swing long trade. And we have a memory support line very close to Friday's close. That prevents us from taking any short trade either. The prudent decision might be to wait for IWM to give us a low risk, high probability trade opportunity. Sector performance analysis. Every week we study 11 macro sectors. We analyze them over 3 review periods. The red bar represents performance of this week, green bar performance of 1 week prior to the red bar, and blue bar performance of 2 weeks prior to the green bar. Together, these 3 bars constitute 4 weeks or about 1 month of performance. Any bar coming to the right of the zero line indicates the sector went up, and a bar coming to the left side of the zero line indicates the sector went down. This week, 7 sectors went up and 4 went down. This implies an overall bullish market. This is the same conclusion that we arrived at from market breadth analysis as well as from broad market ETF technical analysis. Information technology. Earlier, this was the leading sector. It underperformed last few weeks and went up this week by very small percentage. It is not clear whether next week Infotech is more likely to go up or down. You may wait and use the insight from QH, real-time industry rotation, before committing to bullish or bearish trades. Consumer staples and consumer discretionary continue to do well. Using QH, you could catch the exact turning point of these sectors and buy stocks at optimal valuation well ahead of others. Telecom services continues to recover from bottom. Using QH, again, you could buy some optimal valuation stocks just as the sector started to go up few weeks ago. We start our industry analysis by studying the best performing industries of this week. Coal and consumable fuels is the best performing industry. In this industry, wastewater resources gained by more than 34% this month. Using QH industry rotation analysis, you could probably buy WWR at an optimal price and profit handsomely from this 34% move. Another stock, Hallador Energy, in the same coal and consumable fuels industry, created a higher high and pulled back to support in Q hop on chart. You may look for suitable low risk entry in this stock. Let's look at HRNG using Q charts. This is HRNG using at a glance template. The weekly chart shows that for several weeks price went up and this week it pulled back a little bit. The backdrop candle color turned yellow. This week's down move, however, brought the price only to value area in the daily chart. Prior to that, it had already created a higher high. At the right edge, there is no valid Q trade setup. We know that from the Q unambiguous checklists that cover all the four trade setups, one for each of four possible market conditions. At the right edge, HRNG is resting on support, closing just above the yellow direction line. If price goes up from here, it may give us a very low risk swing long trade opportunity. Back to best performing industries. Three of the best performers belong to material sector. These are steel, construction materials, and aluminium. QH industry rotation heat map shows that all of these were weak earlier and now steadily gaining strength. You may look for swing long as well as long term long stock positions in these industries. Another three best performers belong to consumer discretionary sector. They started reversal from bottom few weeks ago. There may still be optimal value buy opportunities in some of these industries. These three consumer discretionary industries that went up strongly this week are computer and electronics retail, multi-line retail, and automotive retail. From best performing industries, we now move to worst performing industries. The worst performing industries are spread across diverse sectors. Three of them belong to energy. QH industry rotation heat map shows that they are weak for a long time. You may be cautious before taking any long in these industries. These three energy industries are oil and gas drilling, oil and gas exploration and production, and energy equipment and services. They are weak for a long time and again became worst performers this week. We also saw earlier that US oil is moving sideways. All these point to the necessity of caution before trying to any long trade in these industries. Healthcare supplies. This is an interesting industry. QH heat map shows that this industry is starting to turn around from the top. It should be from the top, not from the bottom. It was cyan that is bullish for a long time in the industry heat map table and now turning magenta. You may look for swing short opportunity and be cautious of any long position you may have. Every week we also study the industries going up with fast pace. They often end up being the best performers in subsequent weeks. Two utility industries started to go up after a period of decline. You may look for potential long in these industries. They are independent power and renewable energy producers and independent power producers and energy traders. Home entertainment software. This industry went up with fast pace. However, drilling down using QH, you will see that some stocks like EA and ATVI merely recovered from lower boundary to value area. This may actually give low risk short opportunity in the coming week. Let's have a look at one of these stocks using Q charts. This is ATVI, Activision Blizzard, using Q at a glance template. Weekly backdrop template shows ATVI moving sideways, bounded by watermark resistance at the top and memory and watermark support at the bottom. This week's candle is magenta color, that is bearish. However, the shape is bullish. It has a very long lower tail. This shows that price tried to go down but recovered by Friday. The same move is magnified in the daily chart, where it came to the lower boundary and recovered from there for 4 successive days. However, this recovery could bring ATVI only to the value area. It is possible that the recovery was in response to the support provided by the weekly memory and watermark support lines, and also possibly from the support of white very slow direction line in the daily chart. ATVI has already created lower low. Next week, if it tilts down, it will create a lower high. ATVI will be technically in downtrend at that time, and it may give us a low risk trend following short trade opportunity. To conclude, the broad market is clearly bullish. This is displayed by the strength of the market breadth as well as the technical analysis of broad market ETFs. If you are holding long positions that are profitable, it is probably not required to exit them. You may use queue protection signal to protect profit and try to let profit run. As the market continues to be bullish, one may be cautious about entering any short trade. That is all that I plan to share in today's session. Thank you for joining. I look forward to seeing you in the next session. Have a great weekend and trade profitably.